Thank you so much, Scoots, and always good to hear Richard cut off. That's a bonus. Thank you, Scoots. Very kind of you.
We love Richard.
Deep down, very deep down. But no, Mirage coming up next. A little bit of a stronghold for VODS Pro. I think we can all be quite honest about that. But then again, I don't think many people expected LDLC to be able to pick up that first map. But still, it's happened. It was a possibility. But is there a chance on Mirage, or is this a little bit too much
for LDLC? LDLC? Yeah. Absolutely. Okay. I think we're being a bit harsh on LDLC here. I mean, again, I said earlier before the first map, I said I'm a fan of the underdogs, if you will.
Yeah, that's true.
And look, LDLC, they showed, like, even when they were 14-11 down, you could tell that they were going to, you know, they were doing the right things, they were making the right steps, they were making the right team decisions. And that's what brought them back and what turned into an absolutely cracker of a game, might I add.
There's no doubting that.
And, you know, absolutely, I think VODS Pro were favourites on Dust 2. I still think they're favourites. I know LDLC chose that map, but a team like VODS Pro, they're going to be tough to beat on every map. It doesn't mean they're unbeatable, though. And LDLC are well aware of that. And it'd be great to see how these two teams come out.
So let's look into perspective of what we can kind of look at, maybe scoreline-wise, what to expect from the play styles, because LDLT, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, will be starting on the CT side. VODS Pro on the T side. Who's going to really have that edge early on? Do you think the confidence will carry through for LDLC here and they'll be able to convert it nicely into CT?
I think it's a good position for LDLC here. If they're going to take this map out, they want the start that they had on Dust 2.
Yeah.
They've got CT side of Mirage, is that what you said? Is that right?
I believe LDLC do have CT,
that's,
I think.
That's what they want. I'm sure they're feeling good about that. They're happy about that. You know, from a player's point of view, like I said, that's the beauty of Counter-Strike. Every round is up for grabs. That map is over. Now, VODS Pro need to forget about that map, as do LDLC. There's nothing from that game that they can take on to the second. They know their game plan. They know what they need to do, what's happened in the past. It's the past now. Good on them. Well done. I'm sure they're telling that to one another, as are VODS Pro. Don't get down and out. It is a new map. We've got a first round to go for it. And capitalize on mistakes. It seemed to me that LDLC were better at that in that first map. And if they can keep that going, you know.
I'm certainly looking forward, though, to what VODS Pro can bring. I've seen these guys on this map so many times, and every single occasion, it's been pretty damn impressive. The aggression that they show through mid on the CT side themselves is something to be a little worried about. Pasha, once again, an opportunity for him to shine.
Yeah, a great team to watch. I mean, that's the type of stuff. That's what the viewers want. I mean, Pasha, he'd be upset. He'd be well upset after that first game because he played so well. But, you know, the team knows that. And they seem to me, I don't know them personally, but they seem to be those type of boys. They seem to, you know, to want to up their game for their brother, in Counter-Strike, if you will. And that's probably what they'll do. Because, as you said, they are a very strong side, especially on Mirage. So we'll see how they go.
So, ladies and gents, let's get ourselves ready for that second map coming up. We are into the pistol right now. CT side will be LDLC, the current leaders in this best of three, can you believe that? And VODS Pro will be on the T side. So what are we seeing so far that's kind of standing out to you? Any good plays, any starts that are indicative,
pretty basic,
or just standard?
Pretty standard, and it shows, I don't know, maybe it's because of the map, and again, a great entry there. You see,
lovely
pick. First pistol round on Dust 2, they rushed. Now they're pretty much doing a default. They're taking it easy. Maybe now they're showing a bit more respect to their opponents and saying, all right, you mean business, so do we. We'll give you the respect you deserve. And maybe that'll work against them. Maybe that's not what they need to do. Only time will tell.
Well, first kill did come into the hands of LDLC. Their snakes does go down with a lovely little peek. Well, VODS Pro let that rest. I don't believe so, but Maniac stands right in their path. Good work there. Takes down Taz. Good chunk of damage. And Kelly will look to follow up. And that man with that gun is a bit of a terror. And no, don't do it against me. Don't you dare, Kelly. As Bialy will finally get the kill. But right now, LDLC are at the helm. And they will get the first
round. Was that Maniac up there? Getting that intro, I think it might have been whoever
it was
up there on pad. Great work. He put one down to pretty much a one shot. He took another one out, and again, VODS Pro did the right thing. They even though they were a man down, they isolated a zone, so those numbers don't count for anything. Yep. A great work like that. He slowed him down. He gets a kill. He puts one to low HP, and again, they take out that pistol. And that's exactly what LDLC needed.
This is impressive stuff. I worry for VODS Pro, a team that can depend on confidence. Once that does get removed, you see errors occur. You see flaws start to build up, and already.
I know that's an echo, but that's such a great entry, Frank. That really is. He had a scout. I think he had a scout.
Yes,
Asha was looking to make something happen out of nothing, if you will. And just Kelly shutting him down. Almost getting to his mind now. Letting him know, look, you got the guns, mate, but I got one too. Don't you worry about that.
Certainly. yeah, might be starting to work its way into the VODS Pro camp, but still such a good team, so able to do this. But I think it was actually Lerpus who pointed out on Twitter, you know, they're a team that does occasionally start slumping. They do sometimes fall a little victim to these kind of comeback kids who can turn it around on a dime. But let's see right now how this one goes down. Good start towards the A setup. Smokes come down. Jungle's going to be covered. CT's going to be covered. Uzi waiting with Kelly there. And you can see just a little bit of a tap fire coming through, trying to connect on anything possible. But VODS Pro are in on the site. And look at that complete control. Just zoning them out. And here comes Snacks.
That's a great frag there from Snacks.
Brilliantly done. Aggression
and the bomb
in
down.
Point. Bomb planted, as you mentioned. That's going to work wonders, surely, for VODS Pro now.
Absolutely. This is the position they needed to be in.
Well, let's see if Apex can turn it around. It's still a very costly round, regardless, for LDLC.
Bialy doing a good job there.
Yeah, Bialy does have himself the M4, and he's got the shot, but not enough to finish it off, as LDLC will claim a second round, defuse the bomb, and maintain three players alive. And it was dangerous, though.
Considering there were a man down early in the round, they got the bomb down, and they took off two guns off the opponent. So that's great work there from VODS Pro. They'll be feeling good about that one. I'm sure LDLC won't be as happy, though. The round is what matters, and we'll see how they go. This is looking like a full eco from VODS Pro.
Well, you've got, I guess, you know, the smokes taking into account, the CZs. It probably wasn't even the cheapest of ecos we've ever seen. But getting that bomb down, certainly going to help out. And at the moment, a couple of flashes, two smokes. We might see the same thing again. Not too sure if they fancy that, but let's see what they go for. Neo, yeah, it does look as though he's at least going to be doing the jungle smoke coming out. I wonder if we're going to see the same coming across towards the CT and see that push in happening again. Certainly did well for them before. Are they toying with this? Because now Uzi's in position. This could be actually quite painful again, but I love the execution from VODS Pro. They are getting a foot in the door, but they're just not, sadly, getting the kills to boot, as the guns obviously have such an advantage in this situation. It is a clean slate for LDLC. 3-0, VODS Pro definitely trying now, trying to get that bomb down, trying to do any damage possible.
That's what VODS Pro were after. They were trying to get that bomb down, and look, well done from LDLC. It's those little battles that matter. They didn't let them. That's one objective they didn't allow. So they'll be feeling good about that. So, look, first gun round of the game, of the map. So you see already, just on the ecos, the VODS Pro is such, you know, smokes like as if it's a gun round, as if, you know, we want
they
to win this round.
No,
we're not giving up.
So let's see what they have this time through. Last time this happened, it didn't go so well for Pasha. Maybe Neo will do a little better. Nice smoke comes in through the window. Allows a little bit more room to breathe for VODS Pro if they do fancy starting to work their way through mid, but Happy looking like he wants to get aggressive. Snacks might find a counter as Neo starts edging forward. Smoke still in the way. Molly pushing him back. And it's just giving VODS Pro slowly but surely more and more room to breathe and build up to this push. Neo, look at this position.
That's
fantastic.
That Molotov. That Molotov has allowed him in there. So that's great work from VODS Pro.
Can they make anything of it, though? Kelly has already found Taz. That's not what they wanted. It looked like they're starting to execute towards this A bomb site. We've got Bialy going more the standard route. He's been found by Happy, but Neo, in that brilliant position, did catch Kelly, but it's going to be Pasha to find Happy, and now we're going to be left in a 3v2. But so much presence from the CTs towards A is going to make that hard to crack, and now just Neo alive, 1v3. So it's like the first gun round is going LDLC's way, but let's wait and see what he has here. Bomb, oh, that is a dire place to be. Having to push towards 32 seconds. Neo knows the clock is running against him, and Maniac will deal with it. But once again, the execution seems on point there for VODS Pro to an extent. And then
absolutely.
What went wrong?
They walked up a ramp, and there's three LDLC players waiting for you. There's not much you can do about that. Their execution is good. It's almost as if LDLC are well prepared. They know how good these guys are. They know almost know what to expect. So
they know
they're
the
there.
Tricks.
They're ready. Exactly. And that's what's hard about being, you know, the favorite team, if you will. The player, you know, the eyes are on you. You know, they're the ones to watch out for. Exactly. And LDLC doing a great job. They kept composed. And Neo doing a good job to get into a great position and got a frag from there. But Kelly gets that early entry, which puts him again in the driving seat.
And I'll ask you the question, as we are on a little bit of an eco here, but the danger is still present. We can jump back from that if the case may be. But you know, VODS Pro, when they make these pushes, when they make these plays, it is quite apparent. It's not subtle. The smokes are there. The flashes follow.
Yeah.
Is there going to be a point where they might fake it out? Is that going to be a case, or is it just going to be a clean push again and again?
Well, it's, they seem yet to do it. And funnily enough, that gun round, I'm not sure that last round if they did throw any smokes. But even if they did, they were up in their face. They were there at A ramp. They were waiting for them to come around that corner, as if to say, look, throw your smokes. They're behind us now, and now we're in your face. Come at us, mate. But again, on the ecos, they just wanted to get the bomb down. VODS Pro just wanted to get the bomb down.
Okay, so sixth round coming up, five rounds in a row for VODS. So actually, I'm so used to saying it, five rounds in a row for LDLC. It's rising.
That one hurts. Pasha won't be happy about that one.
Did he miss the
he
shot?
He missed the shot. That would hurt.
See, the thing is, as you said, a confidence-based player, everyone knows this with VODS Pro, but when you start not landing these shots, when you start getting out of the game, it's even harder to get
so
over it.
It's so important against a team that seems so well refined. I mean, LDLC...
And look at Apex. Is this confidence once again kicking in for LDLC here?
This is forcing him into a zone. This is exactly what they want to be doing. He's in a fantastic position here to capitalize and we'll see what he can do.
Well, Pasha still looking to maybe make up for that little bit of a missed opportunity earlier on. Apex now given the keys to look a little further. Not going to find too much. And as much as he's not seeing much, it's eliminating places the VODS Pro are not. So they're kind of working out, hence the molly coming in. Obviously the push starting to build, the smokes are coming into effect. LDLC know what's happened. We've seen this push before several times, but this time VODS Pro do have the guns. Can they now hold on? No,
great
so far
entry.
Is the answer. Good work from Bialy opening up there. An entry fragger certainly at the forefront of VODS Pro, but right now 3v4, bomb not yet to go down, but the smoke has just dissipated. Maniac. Waiting it out, Pasha though, looking for a way in, and he's found it. Apex goes down, not expecting that slow play from Pasha, holding back a little, but only getting one from it. 3v2, bomb now down. Look at this position. Maniac has got himself right next to him. I don't know if they're fully aware of this, but they certainly will be after that flash, and there we go. Snacks does find him now. Happy. 1v3, after plant. This looks like the first round VODS Pro will be picking up. Execution has been on point, however. Outside of that, it was a little bit of a struggle, but finally VODS Pro get that well-needed round on the board. But that looked like a struggle rather than that clean, smooth execution we're used to.
Really, you think from the position that Apex was over there in the mid, you'd think LDLC would have capitalized, you know, harder, if you will. But again, it's so tough when, you know, the entries are made. I mean, they made their entry, the revenge was there, but immediately that guy was taken out.
Let's be serious here. Bialy is one of the best players at doing this. It's not something that he's unaccustomed to. He is one of the big opening killers in this, and he has had a fantastic tournament to this date.
Better than me.
I didn't say that. The stats might have done, but I didn't. Anyway, in this one, we are seeing a little bit of a split from VODS Pro, not committing fully anywhere yet, still early in the game. Maybe expecting this play to come out. Apex did go walk around before. Snacks. Maybe aware. Let's find out. Here we go. 1v1, we'll break out. Apex actually picks it up. And that is a big, big impact, surely, onto this round.
Absolutely. Absolutely, it's what they want. It's what they look for almost. Just to get them out of their comfort zone. Just not let them execute the way they want to.
So even just one player with one smoke now missing, it's going to have to be covered somehow. Small chink in the armor may be formed, but let's find out what the four remaining players in VODS Pro can do. It looks like we're seeing what we've become a little accustomed to now in the last couple of rounds. The smokes, the flashes, the nades are being wound up, put down, and A is going to be the side that will be receiving it. Uzi this time maybe a little more aware, flashes out early.
VODS Pro's experience, they're faking this out very well. It's these kills that make the difference.
And right now, one of them only went to LDLC, really, in that exchange, leaving a 3v3 overall. But look how low Apex is. Aniac not sitting great either. They're dedicated to the site, but Uzi still doing work. And the fake, the bomb is at B. Maniac expected it somehow. He knew this was going down, but Pasha slaps him back, and now 2v2. Bomb down by B. Apex not missing a beat. He's going to be straight over there, but the HP pool with LDLC is weak.
Yep.
It's lacking. The T side looking strong.
It's great work there for Pasha. That's a big frag and a second.
Brilliant work from the man. Right on your screens, Pasha now locking this out. Neo will just secure. And it's not pretty, it's not beautiful from VODS Pro, but it's starting to work.
Yeah, and that's all they need. That's all they need. I'm sure Pasha doing a great job, again, as he did in the first game. He's brought it onto the second. The round before that they won, he got a big frag there in the mid-con there. He opened up the round for his teammates over in A. And that frag on Maniac that he just got in that bomb site B is what makes the difference. Because Maniac was in a solid position, and I'm sure he'll be disappointed with himself. He was ready to take both of them down. Pasha says, no, thank you, not today.
This is what I wanted to see a little of here. Apex getting aggressive again. He does make it count, finds one. Nice little follow-up of damage, but didn't get the kill. So Bialy and Taz come out on top. VODS Pro get the advantage, but still, the HP drastically lowers them. They're still around mid. One nade could destroy 50% of what's left alive for VODS Pro here. But regardless of that, 1 minute and 16 here. A lot of damage done, but not much ground gained really from it.
No. I know two players are down for the counter-terrorists here, but I'm sure they're feeling pretty good. They know That's a good frag there from Happy, taking out Pasha. That's their main fragger, if you will, they have been so far this game and one earlier. So but you see, again, they're not letting the numbers, you know, count for them. They're sticking together. They're isolating zones. They're trying to get them into, you know, 3v1s or 3v2s, if you will.
Let's see.
Tough task here for the terrorists.
Oh, especially considering Bialy and Taz are so low. 10 HP each. And Snacks still sitting pretty. Kelly, though, getting a little restless. That's protesting the patience here, and that nade could have been a disaster. Doesn't quite connect, and Kelly playing it smart, playing it cautious, waiting this out. He could be the one to stop this. Snacks seems aware, but the frag will come in for virtus.pro. Snacks claims it, leaving it a 2v2, and it's left to the two who are down so low early on. Bialy and Taz, bomb yet to be planted. 15 seconds left, a wild spray down comes out from Maniac, not gonna work. And now Bialy and Taz still looking to do this. Bomb finally goes down. Happy finds one. Oh, oh but the wow, nade to the feet. Taz keeps hold of it and on such minimal HP.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for LDC. They'll be very disappointed with that one. I think it has to be said that it was that first frag that, like I said, they isolated the zone. They went in there. That first trade went to virtus.pro and that's what got them that round ultimately. They had two players on 10 HP. They stayed back. They let their full HP player go in there, take on a trade, hopefully, hope for the best. And he got the frag. Followed through with the round.
All right, so 5-3 is the scoreline. They're just tuning in here in the second map. First was claimed by ODLC to some surprise, let's say. ODLC is still a very dangerous side. virtus.pro bringing out the A game now, starting to build up, starting to have that little bit of momentum that's very hard to stop. And see if they can convert this cleanly. I can imagine they could do with a nice clean round in this. They've had to fight hard for absolutely everything at the moment. And Kelly just gets absolutely taken out.
Yep.
Obviously, a nice little wallbang spot coming through there for Pasha, takes him down. And at the moment, LDLC struggling to find a bit of a way through. But look at that stack. Does virtus.pro go in front? Surely not. Surely they're just going to go for the nice clean A play. I think they're realizing it's like, ah, the doormat is out and they've left the door open. Let's have a little wander in and get the bomb down. But this is a risk you take, I assume, when you stack outside like this. Sometimes it works.
Yeah, of course, you got to take the chance. You know, you got to pick a side. Use those pistols, use those crossfires, and hope they come at you. And look, a great kill again from Pasha. I know, again, it's just an eco though, but it just opens up the round. Look, I've taken one out. Let's group up. Let's stick together. Let's take these sides. Have my back. I've got yours. That's a great frag then from Uzi. virtus.pro still in the driver's seat for this round. Obviously, though, LDLC probably just want to take some guns off them. Just whatever you want to get in their heads. Don't let them get too confident.
That's a brilliant way to do
great
it.
Great job.
Uzi there finds one. Apex game. Pasha low. LDLC are keeping this one a little close. The bomb, however, is ticking a little too fast. But as you say, get in their heads.
Exactly.
Get the momentum building. Get those guns away from them. And, well, Uzi and Maniac both escape with the AK intact.
That's a big play. And those last two kills coming from virtus.pro, that hurts LDLC. That's not what they wanted. If they could have got those kills and gotten out, that's the mind games. These are the little things that make the difference in the long haul. virtus.pro, though, class. Class is permanent. Oh, they were 5-0 down. They've brought it back to 5-4. They're showing why they're such a threat. They're showing why they're favourites. Great work here from both sides again. virtus.pro just a little bit classier.
Let's find out if they can keep making it stick because Pasha is looking to cause an upset. He does get the first tags of the second. The aggression from LDLC being met by virtus.pro with the early play towards A, but I can imagine this might be reset or are virtus.pro continuing? It looks like they were trying to continue off the back of that, but Apex found Neo. Bialy gets one back right on the bomb site, leaving it down to a 3v3. Smoke's still in place. Everything is there, but possibly what's about to happen. Bialy considering the options. And I think he's going to stick this one through. There we go. Bomb is down. Time limit now to the CTs to make the play back in, but they do find Bialy on the cross away from the site. But there's still Pasha, the man with the AWP, the man who's been dragging virtus.pro through this game. And Taz tucked in on site. Can he do anything? Maniac pushes in. Taz gets one.
Taz.
Kelly does reply. And now Pasha 1v2. Bomb is ticking, but Happy finds him, gets the AWP. Defuse. Do they have a death kit? There we go. I was about to get a little nervous
switching
then.
Up.
Switching it up, but the defuse will come in.
Yep.
Nothing too dangerous.
That's good work there. Again, LDLC, even the rounds they've lost, they've done very well. They're coming in, they're sticking to the game plan, just as they did on Dust 2. They know what they're up against. They're trying to disrupt the play of virtus.pro, if you will. Force them into something they don't want to do, or not as comfortable as they do.
So, talk to me about what's an acceptable scoreline to you? If you're LDLC, you're facing virtus.pro on a map like this for them, where would you feel okay with? Where's your cutoff point?
I think for a map like this, it's tough to say. Look, I really wouldn't want to give up another round. Considering they won that pistol, you wouldn't want to give up another round, especially not against virtus.pro. Not a CT. Not a CT on Mirage.
This could be interesting. Deep smokes coming through. Taz being a little bit nervous towards this. Maybe rightly so, but there we go. Bialy will take down Uzi. Apex tucked in, does get one, goes for the second, gets the second. Big play from Apex. Switches up to the pistol. Don't tell me he can do it. No. Gets denied in the end by Neo. And now 2v2 situation. LDLC are keeping this close. As you said, there's no clean, easy rounds here. No. Even the ones versus pro win.
Yep.
Same thing we said for
LDLC.
Making
it very hard for virtus.pro here. Yeah. LDLC, and that's what they need to be doing. They need to be getting into the heads here.
Nope. There we go. That's one way to do it, literally.
Patience. Very well done here. Now Neo forced in a 1v2 with the bomb down though.
Tough situation. Bomb not planted is right on the site, and they knew, they surely knew that Taz was running that. So they're going to play it calm, play it cool and collected. Neo does make the cross. 38 seconds. Happy and Maniac against him. Oh, and then four. We're going to wait for him to rotate off the side. Oh, not sure if that's what he wanted there, but he does go for the peak. He spots out one, not going to get it happy. Keeps it close and gets another round on the board.
Yeah, LDLC happy about that one, obviously. Look, LDLC, they seem a bit better. I mean, I don't know. I've versed these guys over in Poland.
And yep.
We did pretty well considering that. I mean, I'm pretty happy with our performance considering because, look, they're showing up virtus.pro. I know virtus.pro got four rounds in a row, and I know they brought it back to 14-11 yes. First map, but LDLC, they just seem ready. They just seem on board. They've done their homework. They're playing well, one another. You know, they're getting the entries. They're cross-firing well. They're forcing virtus.pro to do what they don't want to do, pretty much.
It's impressive considering virtus.pro are such a similar style as well. Exactly. They are virtus.pro. They're there for a reason, and the aggression, the confidence is with LDLC. For now, things can still change. I'll just see on the CT side, but Kelly will open up on towards Snacks in this mixed bag buy. Not looking too great now. The Galil and the P250 in the hands of Neo. Happy waiting for these flashes to come through to go for the peak. And not the first one land, and naturally, he's pretty flashed up. Bialy will be able to take him down, but avenged immediately by Apex. So, 4v3, advantage
in
CT.
A good position here, virtus.pro. Oh, but that's a good frag again
were.
From Apex. Such a solid player.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he knew the bomb was down straight
frags.
Away, but played so well there. And now Taz left in a near on impossible situation for most players,
wow.
But Kelly shuts him out. And another round on the board. And as you were saying, brilliant position. It could have been a good play for virtus.pro then. They weren't
yep.
in a bad spot.
Yeah, but it's those little 1v1s that make the difference. He was in the position to win the round for virtus.pro there, but he got taken out there by Apex. And Apex, such a solid play. We saw he actually top fragged that first game. We'll give it a lot of credit to Kelly, but Apex, he just makes these little kills once every now and then that just means the round. He won't frag, and if he doesn't frag, the team won't win. It seems like that kind of player. Such a solid player to have.
Certainly lovely right now, and Kelly.
Great shot.
Nice little opener there. Passion goes down, and you got to say, if there's anyone you wanted to take down with the AWP to get a little bit of a confidence point across, it's going to be Pasha.
Yeah.
The more on tilt he goes, if that can even happen, the better it feels for LDLC. And at the moment, a bit of an eco round coming in for virtus.pro. Nothing too dangerous just yet, and the bomb has been caught a glimpse of by Happy, so I'm sure the LDLC side should be able to play to this one. A little bit low there, but Snacks did find Kelly, so got to be a little careful. Those CZs, we know they can do damage. You don't want to take it too lightly. Snacks gets himself the AWP. If he gets away with this, that's not too bad, I guess, but...
Right around so far. They've taken an AWP off LDLC, and that's what they want when on eco.
Really impressive. I think he knows that one.
Yeah.
Backing out a little bit, getting maybe to a comfort zone, watching the push around the back. As Bialy left a bit of a free agent. Let's see if he can get himself a gun. 40 seconds to do so. Maybe waiting for a player to get a little bit lacking that discipline, go for the peak.
Yep.
And might be able to find one, to be fair. The LDLC are starting to roam. They're starting to think, we might want to get that AWP away from Snacks. Am I going to hands of Pasha? And might start to hurt, but still, 20 seconds. Snacks in a good position here. Much far away from the action, and they're playing out smart, but it's bright.
Yeah.
No doubt about that.
LDLC, patient. What they need to do.
I get a little nervous when people start
That's
jumping this.
That's a great frag from Snacks.
It certainly is. Snacks
Not enough time,
Apex.
Though. The timer will go.
Oh,
these
my
are great
word.
Frags. LDLC
Beautiful.
Won't be happy about that one.
Giving up two players then, pretty much.
Yep. And the AWP.
Oh, no! Maniac!
Almost
just
takes
denied.
Out the last as well. That's good work there.
Definitely was.
Look, it's good work. You saw early in that round Kelly getting that first frag on Pasha, yep. As you said. He got that frag and he ran. He was gone. He's like, look, we know they're on pistol, but let them do what they want. Well, they're showing respect. And that's what they should be doing. They're still, they're playing composed. They're not getting hungry. They're trying to not make mistakes. Just great work from VODS.pro to get him that AWP, to put him in that position to almost, you know, get the bomb down, if you will.
You can never underestimate VODS.pro. Let's be completely honest. Regardless of the scoreline right now, they're the team that can turn it on a dime. You just need that one player to maybe step up. The little bit of issues with cohesion, whatever's going wrong, it could be smoothed out in a moment's notice. But for now, LDLC are still in the lead. 9-4. Will it stay that way? Oh, Kelly does not get the opener maybe he wanted there. We are seeing Snacks still with the CZ. Everyone else getting the AKs, getting the M4s. Looking okay in this one. 1 minute left. VODS.pro working their way through the map. They've got a good bit of control so far. Pasha locking off the little connector right there. Where are they going to hit, though? Two players still on B for LDLC. No one rotating. No one getting caught off guard just yet. And I think they know they're becoming pressured through mid towards B. VODS.pro are building up.
Now you can see what they're doing here. They're getting into good positions and they're waiting. They're waiting. They're waiting for their opportunity. They're waiting for LDLC to perhaps just step out of line. Just that.
Testing that patience.
Exactly. Exactly.
Not a bad plan.
LDLC showing great patience, not giving me anything.
Oh, this is a beautiful trap laying in wait. Smoke will go down, finds a little more time, and actually Kelly will drop down, and here comes the execution from VODS.pro. Going to make a bit of a mad dash towards B, and it's not gone too badly at all. Neo and Taz find the kills they needed, and now it's retake time, if not challenge for LDLC, but bomb is down and ticking. Time limit now against them. And Taz, Snacks, and Pasha in their way. Happy goes for the peak. It's Apex to be claimed first, and a well-needed round if it's going to be picked up here for VODS.pro. Happy weighing up the options. Ollie's buying time. Every second that goes past, you know it's frustrating for this man, and they just got bulldozed out of this side, but he might be able to get a good couple on the way through. No, doesn't catch a glimpse, sadly. He's going to back away and maybe find another angle. Oh, they're missing each other by centimeters here, ladies and gents, but...
Now you can see what happened there. Oh, I think it was Kelly over in the bomb site B. He a split second too late. If he was there just a touch earlier, he would have had a look on short there when they're coming into B, which perhaps could have got him an entry and then led to two and or three, but unfortunately got caught off guard, almost didn't expect him to be there and misses his shot. And again, VODS.pro capitalized on that mistake.
Yep, 9-5. Last round of the first half. How are the scorelines looking? Is this a good performance by one team or something that's a fairly standardized sort of scoreline we're seeing between CT and T?
For me, from my experiences, definitely. This is about right for us. This is a CT side of that. This is, you know, VODS.pro won't be, you know, too distraught by this.
Well, they might be soon if this pays off, but Bialy says no. Does take down Apex, but a one-for-one exchange. Information gathered, not sure if it was worth it, but let's find out where VODS.pro may take this. A lot of time on the board, and VODS.pro once again doing that complete control through mid. I love this play from this all-encompassing towards this. Kelly might find a little bit of an issue very, very soon. VODS.pro continue that slow push, and they really are just testing the metal here of LDLC.
Yeah, absolutely.
Don't tell me he's caught a glimpse, and this is the problem. If LDLC get too confident, get that little bit too arrogant with the peaks, to be caught out, but right now Happy has a chance, has an opportunity, doesn't land the shot. My God, he leaves Stacks on 8 HP, but Kelly did find...
full advantage of that great position he was in. Got the frag that he needed.
And let's see if VODS.pro go where LDLC seem to be expecting them to appear. Pasha trying to right off the corners, find out where these guys are. Taz found Kelly, so 3v3,
but... That is a big frag.
Normally, I doubt this on this sort of HP pool, but then again, we saw Taz, and I think it was Neo before on 10 HP, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm finding it hard to doubt them, but I think in the moment, we're going to find out if they can find that final push. Will it be 10-5? Let's find out. Taz and Pasha.
They need to be quick.
Yeah, 9 seconds left. They know it. It's going to be an all-in. Maniac waits in such a beautiful position, just holding passively. Pasha, he's getting the bomb down, but there we go.
He had no choice.
Kill
he had
coming.
To. Yeah, absolutely. Great work there. And as I said earlier, 5 rounds was the rounds that they, you know, didn't want to get concede more, if you will. And look, again, it just seems like the same as Dust 2. I know it's a CT-sided map.
Yes.
But LDLC are looking really good. They're looking really confident. They're playing well.
And I think that's such an important factor here. As you said, it's map by map. It doesn't necessarily transfer so easily. Obviously, the confidence will be there, the feeling that, okay, this is good. We've got room to breathe. We can go to a third map if necessary for the guys on your screen right now, LDLC. It's in place, but they're playing so well. They're playing nicely. Yep. VODS.pro are being challenged. They've not had a smooth road because, let's be honest here, This is a strong map for VODS.pro.
Yeah, absolutely.
From start to finish.
No, absolutely. This game is far from over. I mean,
oh, yeah.
It's still anyone's game. It'd be great to see how VODS.pro... I mean, looking at their faces, they don't seem too happy with themselves, and I don't think they should be, although I'm sure they know deep down, they know they can bring this one back. But, I mean, look, these are the little things. This is it. You know, it's just a shoulder rub. It's just a shoulder rub, but they're feeling good. Look at that. Smiles all around. That's what they want to see.
It's a stark contrast, isn't it?
Absolutely. And that's just because of, you know, who VODS.pro are and who these guys are versing. And they know that. They are, like I said, they are the underdogs. They have the tougher task ahead of them. But look, again, VODS.pro, far from over.
See, and the thing is, you look at it in the perspective of underdog to reigning champion. All the pressure is on VODS.pro to perform. LDLC coming in and picking up a map surprised so many. So they're on this high note, they're feeling good, they're feeling fine at the moment, they can go to the third map if needed. Whereas VODS.pro, it's all on them, and they're a team that do take this emotionally and personally. They're not the guys that just kind of throw it in the background, they're not the clinical kind of teams. You've heard Taz before, I don't need to tell you guys at home the varying interviews, especially from G3, Gfinity, not too long ago, the man who thought they were down and out by the group stages, but then turned it around coming into the tournament. They're a team that needs that emotion, they need that passion. And well, we'll find out if they can find it in the next half. Obviously, a lot on the line here. And at the end of the day, it's just terrifying to think that VODS.pro might not be joining us any further.
Terrifying for some, joyful for the others. Look,
it's a good point.
Tough to say. This pistol round is so important. So important.
There's going to be a pressure moment. It's going to be now. VODS.pro need this one. LDLC, they'd love it. But right now, 10-5 in favor to the T-side, newly appointed T-side LDLC. It's VODS.pro on the CT side with only 5 rounds to their name. As you said, this pistol would work wonders. And look what's happening on the CT side. They are focusing a little more towards one side than the other. Pasha dancing with Maniac. Let's see if LDLC can claim this. You've got to be thinking the nerves might be with VODS.pro now. Those every single peek they make might contain, you know, the yes or the no to which way this round goes. But
they need this round. VODS.pro need this round. It's LDLC execute.
They're just pushing through. They just bulldozed. They literally did a VODS.pro to VODS.pro.
Look at Taz, they're going to kiss.
Taz is right in front of you, buddy. Apex finally goes down, but Uzi replies, and LDLC, they're not stopping. Bialy and Snacks, just standing. Snacks is, though, on the right side.
Here.
Good spot. Nade comes through. Smoke goes out. Gets found. Happy. Claims him. And well, Bialy 1v4. LDLC, I'm going to ask you to break this down for me any second once this round is done and dusted, because we're just going to watch Bialy fall as LDLC claimed the first round in the
well
second
done.
Half.
They, like you said, they did pretty much what VODS.pro did in that first pistol round. That was their momentum. They actually took it to them. You know, they went early. They went straight into their faces. You know, at one point,
slow play,
two of them
nothing.
Were hugging at one point. That's how much in each other's faces they were.
Unbelievable confidence, sheer just brutality. There's no messing around here.
Absolutely.
They want to put VODS.pro out of their misery, and that is the perfect way to begin this one. But there's still danger ahead.
Absolutely. LDLC right now will probably take this easy. They've got the pistol round that they needed, and again, it's Pasha with that.
Got to be
scout.
Careful.
It's just such a big thing now. I mean, I'm from Australia. This is still pretty new to us. These are these little meta games that we take back with us. And look, with in the hands of, you know, Pasha, it's a legitimate strat.
It certainly is. And you can never underestimate this. As you mentioned, the scout, one, two, the CZs. And this positioning, Pasha finds Maniac.
Here.
My God, that is a good bit of revenge.
Hits
there
another.
From what happened on Dust 2. Gets the tag, as you mentioned. Not going to get much more, surely. Surely not. Pasha finds a second, tags up the third. Oh, my word.
The
this is unbelievable.
Juggernaut.
Unbelievable. 3v2. Kelly, low, Happy, still sitting pretty. Goes in for the challenge. Pasha still fights, but Happy claims. Now 2v2. Bomb yet to go down. Can they pressure? Can they find that little weak spot in LDLC's armor here? Bialy tries to claim it, but Happy stops, and now all on Taz. 1v1, he needs this, he wants this. And now Happy wants to stop him. 36 seconds, bomb not in the T-side's hands. Taz knows that. Surely spotted out, goes for the peak, but Happy, gets it.
Fantastic performance here from Happy. I mean, so unlucky VODS.pro there. Pasha again with
how
an
much
unbelievable
more can he do?
Jumping headshot with the scout. I mean, look, he did what he had to do. I mean, I don't know how many more players he had after that, but again, Happy has been, he's had a great game this one. Happy, he's stepped it up. He's like the Apex. He's getting those few rounds.
It's 21-8.
Well, there you go. Well, there you go. Well done, Happy, mate. And happy he should be, I'm sure.
How can you even deal with these guys right now? Pasha is fighting with everything he has. Two players tagged up there, Uzi and Kelly.
Look at that.
doesn't equate to anything right now because no one else is there. No one's backing this up. They're not being able to lock these guys down. And this is going to be 13-5. Now, if VODS turn this around, it'll be the best comeback I've seen in a long, long time. But right now, LDLC have that high point. They're on that ledge. And let's put yourself in VODS Pro shoes right here. You've got five rounds to your
far
name.
From over.
Are you still round by round?
Round by round, exactly. And they know this. They know it's not over. And then, look, it can't be over. They can't have that mentality. And if they do, well, then, yeah, it is over. But I'm sure they don't feel that way. You know, they lost that pistol. Again, that's such a big round for Team LDLC. And they needed it. They got it. And, look, it's all on VODS Pro now. We'll see how they, you know, take these gun rounds.
Does pick up the Pasha's choice of weapon, but that scoreline is looking more and more disastrous. And at the start of this game, if you said to me VODS Pro would not be going beyond this point, I don't know what I'd say to you, but you can see it there. They've called a little bit of a timeout. I think they want to talk things through, and I don't blame them. They have the option there, and it's time to discuss. It's time to mull over what is happening. Where are the issues? How can they fix it? And I want to ask you the question as a player yourself, and I've always liked the differences in mentalities between players and teams. When you're up against a team that's clearly winning, and adaption is always a big point of things, how much do you adapt? How much are you willing to change? Because obviously you have your set plan. You have your the way you play. How much can you change that while still keeping the upper hand? Is there a right amount?
Look, that's the beautiful thing about VODS Pro. They've got so much depth in their gameplay, in their squad. They can adapt. Yeah. They just seem to be, and that's probably why they've taken this time, and they just seem to be unable to. There's almost a mental block. And that's only a credit to LDLC. Yeah. VODS Pro aren't necessarily doing anything wrong as opposed to...
doing it right.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So, you know, it'd be interesting to see what they're saying. You can see the emotion in their faces. They don't want to lose this, obviously. And look, in contrast, LDLC, they're feeling good. They're feeling confident, so they should. And listen... This is a big play from VODS Pro taking this time out because, look, this is just as important as that pistol round. If LDLC can win this gun round, they're taking it out. However, I still think VODS Pro should win this. I don't know why. I don't know how.
But you can't doubt these guys. You know, even at a scoreline like this, it's so hard to suddenly think that actually VODS Pro might not make it further than right now. But Neo there, Taz, everyone on your screens, Pasha, right up close and personal, but it will be Taz, the one taking the reins with VODS Pro, leading now as the captain, as the guy in the game to call out where they're going. It's down to him to get his boys back in this one. A passionate player, and he needs everyone around him to find that form, and let's see if they can do it. Your thoughts towards this? Are you still sticking with VODS Pro here?
Look, from the beginning, I said LDLC. Let's get that clear.
Oh, all right, okay.
Look, LDLC right now, they just seem to have done their homework better.
Yeah.
They just seem better prepared. It showed in Dustu. It's showing so far in Mirage. Oh. And look, VODS Pro, the favourites, they've got a tough task ahead of them. Though I'm sure... Yeah,
if anyone can.
It's not over yet. If anyone can, exactly. And they can. And LDLC are well aware of it. And LDLC know that. So... That's what's going to make it even harder for VODS Pro. They're not going to make those mistakes, and you can see it in those gun rounds. They weren't making the mistakes. They weren't letting VODS Pro make those frags that they needed. LDLC looking absolutely fantastic so far against the champions.
13-5, we are back underway here. Round 19 coming up. Currently LDLC firmly leading this one, but VODS Pro took the time. They wanted to make the differences, but it looks like LDLC want to prove a point here. They look like they want to kind of smash this into pieces straight away. And well, Bialy already says no. Apex is found. Bialy gets a second. He's a man that you want on form. He's consistently played well when VODS Pro picked up his titles and put themselves towards the later stages of tournaments, towards the semis or the grand final itself. So right now, 5v3, two big openers for Bialy.
Yeah, well done there. That's exactly probably what they talked about. That's exactly what they needed. Two headshots as well. Quick and smart.
Impact done. Let's see if they can find the end of this though, because look at Kelly, he's going hunting. He's going to search around. He's Kelly! That is not how you get yourself to the top. Pasha gets gifted the kill on a plate and says thank you very much. Taz will find Maniac and now just happy left alive. I love the idea, but I'm sorry, Happy. I don't think it's going to be here. VODS Pro seem to have got themselves a little bit of a better place. They worked it out. Whatever happened in that chat, Bialy came out and got two kills back to back.
Yeah, look, even though considering that, I mean, Kelly was in a fantastic spot. He was in the middle of two of them, not looking at him. Had he have looked, you know, we didn't know what could have happened. So he would be quite disappointed with that effort, though. Look, that means he's just feeling the pressure. I'm sure LDLC are. That's not what they want to be doing. They don't want to be making little mistakes like not checking your corners, not checking, you know, your flanks and
things
like that.
Can't get complacent, can you now?
Absolutely not.
13-6, virtus.pro finally building a big round for them. They needed that in every shape of what it could mean. And now we are going to be seeing the T side looking like they're going to go for a bit of an aggressive start here. Just on the eco, CZ's in play. Taz will enjoy a double, get to the triple, and may even look for more. There's the fourth. Taz making it look easy, buddy. There's now 1v3. I was about to doubt
Apex
this.
Says no.
But yeah, Apex, let's never consider this man to be incapable. There we go. Neo will watch across in a nice, smart way, and they get the round. Once again, it's not flashy, it's not beautiful, but it's getting virtus.pro on the scoreboard.
Exactly what they wanted. Two rounds in a row. They lost the pistol. They've regrouped. They did that. They took the time out that they needed. They took out that first gun round. They've forced them onto an eco, and they've got the second. Now, it's all on LDLC here. They're feeling it. I mean, this is why virtus.pro, this is why it's their favorite map. This is why this game wasn't over, even at 35 up. It'd just be interesting to see how LDLC react.
And I quite like the way LDLC just constantly try and be aggressive almost. They were just looking for it, looking to maybe instantly crush that bit of work that was put in by virtus.pro in that little timeout.
Yep.
But at the moment, which they're slowing down.
Technically is the right decision, I feel.
It is. I tend to agree, but it just didn't go their way. And clearly you guys at home are wanting virtus.pro to turn this round. They're on the right track for now, but things swap and change so fast here. 1 minute and 10, LDLC slowing things down. More cautious play, clearly realizing that the game is not over. There is still threat here around every corner, but at the moment, Yali waiting this out. This could be rather beautiful. Not going to be the case. Apex somehow gets him first. I don't know how this man is consistently doing this.
I don't know how I shot him in the face there either, because I'm pretty sure he could only see his feet.
He made it happen. Doesn't matter. Apex, he can do the job. And now virtus.pro forced to make these choices. And look at it. Literal rotation. Absolutely perfect.
Fantastic
clockwise
play strategically here from LDLC. Forced. Look at that. There's three over at bombsite B. They've made him feel that's where they're going. And now Taz here, he has to be able to pull up something big here.
You wanted a player in this spot. Would you pick Taz? Not sure, but you're going to find out right
that's
now. Double
down
for Taz. Halts them in their tracks and gives a chance for the rest of virtus.pro to make that rotate to get to the A site. Snacks gets there first. Finds Apex. Now Happy and Maniac in a little bit of trouble, but look at this play from Maniac. I don't want to give too much away. I'm not sure how much they can hear on that stage, so I'm going to keep myself a little quiet right now. But at the moment, bomb is ticking away. virtus.pro with three men standing. Finally, Pasha will find him.
Yeah,
and
credit
there
to Taz. Great work there from Taz. He had to perform. He was there by himself. He was isolated. Takes down two. You know, that's exactly what they needed from him. And that keeps, that's a big round. I mean, really, that should have gone to LDLC and just that, those two frags.
The rotate, like everything was looking like it was theirs.
But again, LDLC did what they needed to do. They're making the right decisions. And so long as they keep this up, you know, virtus.pro is still a big task ahead of them.
It's not going to be a short road. It's certainly going to be a bit of a long path for the virtus.pro boys to walk down. But Taz, once he gets these kills coming in, you know, people question performances of captains consistently throughout CS, and if he's doing the work while doing all the hard work,
Apex
Kelly
again.
But Apex is opening up. It's like, who gets the first, Apex, or is it going to be Bialy? Yep. But then again, we saw Taz locking down two on the push, so every single player, it seems, being able to step up here.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, look, that's a big frag for LDLC. This is how they started the last round, but they ended up losing that one. We'll see if they can capitalize better. And again, Pasha there in a great position.
Can't underestimate that man, Bialy.
Taking out Apex.
Finds one. Bialy is low though. And that nade will connect. Pasha did reply, and this looks like it's going much better for virtus.pro. Clean back-to-back kills. And Maniac, I don't think he can do much here, surely not. His bomb is surrounded by virtus.pro members. He's looking for a way in. And that might be just it. This might be what the doctor ordered, and he does take down one. Not sure if he's going to expect the second so quickly, but he certainly knows where he is now. Flash comes out. Oh, the tag, but not the frag. Neo will lock down, and virtus.pro are building. We said there's a chance, a small chance, that they could do it. And at the moment, they're on the right place.
Absolutely. Look, LDOC again. They made the right. They did the right thing. They made the right decision. They got that entry frag that they were after. But VODS.pro is so strong. I mean, they couldn't capitalize again on that man advantage. And look, what the LDOC were doing is correct. It's what they need to be doing. It's just a matter of capitalizing on that situation they put themselves into.
Moment. CZ's back in place for LDLC. Young team like this, in a way, might start feeling the nerves, but maybe not. Uzi did find Pasha, so if you wanted to start, that's certainly going to be given to you. So right now, VODS.pro, looking to lock it down, make sure they minimize any threat that come through. Just thinking back to the execution that VODS.pro pulled out on this T-side when they're looking towards this site, it was pretty damn phenomenal. And wondering if LDLC would consider something like that. Only really Apex with the smoke, so it's going to be a bit of a all-in if they do go for this. And ready and waiting, there will be one man. It will be Bialy at the forefront, warming himself up pretty damn well so far. Smoke will come in, adjust the sights towards Palace, and here we go. Maniac makes a way. Nom, a great deal connecting for Bialy. He does eventually pick up Maniac. Taz chimes in for one, and there we go. Threat contained until now. Apex and Kelly not done just yet, but they're so low, they're so weak. But can they do anything? Can they get a gun? Can they get that bomb down? 34 seconds. Kelly with a lot of questions now. Looking for the answer. And there we go. Snacks locks it down, gets another one on the board. And it's just that slow building pressure. That's what these guys can do. And surely LDLC are going, what the hell just happened? Where did these rounds suddenly come from? How can they find their footing back into this?
Look, it hurts for LDLC because these rounds are close. I mean, even that was an eco and they did a very good job.
Yep.
And in the earlier gun rounds, like when it's so close and when it's continuously close and you just can't seem to win when you should or you know, could have, you don't take those opportunities, it hurts. It builds up. And LDLC just don't need to not let it get in their Pasha. Again, in a great aggressive position, taking out Happy.
Yeah, and LDLC starting to look a little different in play, a little bit more cautious, a little bit more secondary. But let's see what they can do. Right now, they're building. And that's certainly a great brick.
Again, Apex, just headshotting for fun.
This guy has been an absolute monster throughout this.
Absolutely.
And if they don't find a way back into this, such a shame. He's had a phenomenal, phenomenal map. My VODS.pro adjusting, finding their footing. So the execution may start to begin. As you said, this is a CT-sided map. It's your opinion. And stats generally do support that. But we are seeing LDLC still keep themselves a little close here. But Taz finds Kelly, finds out where the push is beginning. Uzi did get Taz a little earlier back and forth. But right now, Neo is under severe pressure. Apex got caught and now it's Maniac in a 1v2. Pushes in, he gets one. 1v1 now, Maniac up against Pasha. 28 seconds, bomb now in hand. Pasha does have the AWP, he's got the CZ. Smoke goes in. Not gonna plant it, he's trying to call Pasha's bluff here. Let's see. He doesn't know where he is, that's the thing, but he's found
great
him! And Maniac pulls it out there.
Round.
Finally breaking the building trend from VODS.pro.
Yeah, well, and this round actually, VODS.pro were unlucky not to win because I think it was Neo there in the next to the van in bomb site B. Did such a great job. Got a couple of frags, stayed alive for so long just to displace, just to disrupt LDLC, and ultimately turned into a 1v2. And that's what it is. It's those special moments. It's needed.
And I'm terrified right now for VODS.pro. I can't help but say it. 14 to 10, that scoreline starts looking worrying at that point. Two rounds and LDLC.
Worrying it is. Worrying it is, Lauren. But listen.
Surely VODS.pro know the mentality in this, though.
Of course. Look, I think they're on a force buy here right now. This is such a big round. This hurts. I'm sure they're feeling the pressure right now. If LDLC can keep their calm, keep doing what they're doing, because it has been working. These rounds that they're losing, they're still very close rounds. And I'm sure they're well aware of that.
Smokes, nades, put down by LDLC. 1 minute and 10 seconds. And Apex starting to look towards be working through, but Pasha's there. Pasha halts down one, gets not the second actually, Neo found Maniac, but Neo on the bomb site being the pivoting turret and held back LDLC.
They were on a false
point.
They really
needed
that.
Pressure moments, and Neo certainly handling that pressure with the AWP play. Surprising really to see him running with that, but
Not necessarily. And you see, that's such a big round. It's amazing because now LDLC are on the eco. Now they've got no money. Now they're struggling. Now this should be a 14-12. Now all of a sudden,
game
again,
on.
it's almost as if, look, we'll take five, we'll give you one. And if it goes at that rate, look, Virtus Pro are going to take over. Oh, Kelly with the
glass cannon.
You see, one of them had, I think, 6K. He's given him the AWP. He's saying, look, you know what, go for it. See what you can do. And this is exactly what they're going to do. They're going to have one guy, a couple of guys hang around him and see what he can force, just like Pasha with the scout.
The glass cannon in play. No armor, no nothing. Just the AWP. This could open things up. Let's find out. Let's wait and see. Because Pasha is keeping his eyes on it, as is Neo, but cautious play from Kelly. Doesn't want to overstep the mark. As you said, this round here, you don't want to give this man too much room to breathe. We know he can do big things when he's under pressure. Obviously, warming up a little, needs to be a little cautious, but 52 seconds left. LDLC slowly edging, and here we go. Neo does finally hear that AWP rattle off a shot, backing away. We saw the damage he could cause just from seeing it on this side, as Pasha does find Maniac. Pasha now surrounded by LDLC. Apex does claim him. Now 4v4. M4 in play now. He's getting more and more dangerous. Kill by kill that LDLC claim, and now they have changed their sights, they've adjusted accordingly, and Taz will be the one to be on the receiving end. He's going to get the first. Uzi is down. Dangerous play from the left side, but Taz and Bialy dealing with the threat. And oh, Kelly still stays alive, but Snacks gets the final one. And even on just an eco with an AWP, it's still so dangerous here.
Absolutely. Such an important two down there from Taz from that position in between those boxes there towards eight. Look, it has to be said, well done. 252,000 viewers. Keep up the work, guys. Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
It's beautiful.
It's in your face. This is what we want to see. Team LDLC taking it to Virtus Pro. Virtus Pro taking it on the chin and bringing it back.
14-12, Virtus Pro. Scoreline looking a little better. But LDLC up with guns this time. We saw the damage caused with just a couple of CZs and the AWP. This time, a little bit more firepower, a little bit more bite to their bark.
As good as Virtus Pro are doing, they're still feeling the pressure. LDLC are still, should be anyway, feeling a bit better about themselves.
Oh, but Neo does great work taking down Kelly. Apex immediately replied by Apex towards Bialy.
Yep.
Neo didn't quite spot that one out, sadly. And we'll be seeing it leaving in a 4v4.
What hurts for LDLC there is those frags were in different positions, so
it doesn't really complement each other.
The CT sides are still in favour here as Maniac takes the site. And
caution. He knows where Neo is, and well, Neo will go down. Almost the follow-up for Maniac there. Uzi does claim it towards Snacks. And now Taz and Pasha.
Great work from Maniac.
Incredible pressure situation. 15 rounds would be on the board if they pick this up. Pasha flashes in, finds Apex, 2v2. Bomb is ticking, happy on the side with Uzi. Couple more seconds. Taz starting to edge in. Pasha looking for the angle. He's been spotted. He's been found. Uzi claims it. Now Taz in a 1v2. Happy on the left. Uzi on the right. And they claim it. They are almost.
What a round.
Almost there.
What a round. They're
almost
so close. So close yet so far. I'm telling you now, Virtus Pro did not write them out yet. Great work there from Maniac getting that entry and almost taking out that second guy. But again, great revenge work over in that bomb site, isolating those players and capitalizing.
15-12. Money situation for Virtus Pro here.
They're again on a force by. They were on a force by 2-3 rounds ago, I think it was, and they took out that round. Look.
Match point. Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. LDLC on the verge of something that no one really thought was that possible. We had a couple of doubts, maybe, that Virtus Pro wouldn't pick this up. There's seconds of it.
Again, mine was just hope. I didn't believe it. It was just hope.
Let's see how this goes.
An absolute monster this game. I can't believe it. He's headshot every single thing he's seen, especially early in the round. And that's the difference, ladies and gentlemen. That's the difference. And that's what LDLC needed.
They're so close to this full execution on towards A. Only Taz in their way right now. Pasha biting with Happy in mid, but Apex found
again.
Taz. A is open and ready for taking.
Apex again.
Again. Three rounds. Oh my God. Neo now, the last man standing, 1v4. Virtus Pro.
The pistol.
Might be done here. He has nothing but
Apex,
a pistol.
Congratulations.
What a player. What a player.
Wow.
What a team. And what a phenomenal display from LDLC. Virtus Pro just couldn't do it. And LDLC closed it out.
Congratulations. Well done, LDLC. Well done, Apex. As fitting as it was, that jumping USB headshot it was for Kelly, I think it was. Apex with a four down. Absolute monster this game. Oh, well done.
Unbelievable.
Congratulations.
Look how much it means to these boys. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause. They just fought their absolute hearts out for
well
that
done,
one.
Well done, LDLC.
Unbelievable. So well played. So well played. You know what, guys?
To say.
A moment like this is near and unbelievable.
No.
I think this
is, as an underdog myself, this is what I want to see. And that's the beauty of this game. It is possible.
Let's remind ourselves exactly how this happened. Because a lot of us at home, watching in this audience, may not believe what we've just witnessed. But let's get that video rolling to remind you what we've just seen.
Can you believe it?
To secure the final kill in that round.
Oh, no.
All right, well, there you have it. That was the clincher on the first map. And second map, you know, virtus.pro does all the right things. They call that timeout when they need to, and they take rounds after it. The train starts rolling in their favor. But LDLC just says, you know, no, not really going to happen.
I'm really impressed, especially by Opex, you know, taking an entrofrag pretty much every single round. It wasn't an entrofrag, it was a turnaround kill going into 4v4, and obviously the terrorist having the advantage out of that. In all the crucial rounds in the end, he got that so important first frag for the terrorist, and just coming up huge. And what I was thinking during this game is like, hey, is Virtus choking? No, they're not. I mean, they're normally playing better under pressure and being down, chasing up. They don't choke. So LDLC is just, I'm kind of speechless by their performance here. They were playing so good. I'm really impressed.
I mean, again, we all basically said, okay, well, Mirage, virtus.pro, we're going to go to Nuke, you know?
Well, I just want to put this into context about how big an upset this is. Okay, so in the last 10 times virtus.pro have played Mirage, they lost once, and that was 16-13 to Na'Vi and Starladder. You go back another 5 maps, they lost again to Na'Vi on Mirage. But out of the last 20 times they played it, they've lost twice. They don't lose Mirage. It's so rare. And they not only lost it, I mean, at one point, it was really slipping away from them. They had to call a timeout just to get back into it to make it respectable. What LDLC have achieved today is absolutely huge. It blows the tournament wide open. I'm speechless, absolutely speechless. And when does that ever happen, right?
Yeah, and we've got some stats, you know, and as they pull that up, you know, again, like, they are the reigning EMS1 champions, right?
Yep.
So we're going to have possibly a repeat in maybe Fnatic, but certainly virtus.pro is not going to do it again, you know? So, crazy. Walk us through the stats. Yeah.
Well, I'll echo Emil's sentiments about Apex. Entry frag every round, but I want to give special credit to Happy as well. He's the guy who calls. He's the guy, you know, and a lot of in-game leaders don't frag. And look what he's done there. He's almost been the top frag. Absolutely huge from him.
Yeah.
So just incredible play. And I've got to say as well, Taz had a pretty poor dust too. Stepped it up massively there. But again, I mean, I'm absolutely speechless. Did anyone stand out as having maybe a poor game for you, Emil?
Not really. I mean, snacks in the bottom there. But it was not like he didn't take his kills. I think it was just LDLC being the better team today. And I mean, Virtus, as I said, they don't choke. It's just LDLC performing way better, and I'm really impressed. I did not see this one coming. Not on Mirage. I mean, Dust 2, pretty wide open.
Yeah.
Nuke could have gone pretty much either way, but Mirage, it was like 100%. I would have bet all the skins in the world on that. No, but basically, it's...
Not that you bet, but if you
did
bet,
yeah, exactly.
Right?
Yeah. You know what I mean. Yeah, but it was such a wide open, or I mean, such an easy call to call virtus.pro on Mirage, because just like you said, they don't lose, and looking back at LDLC's history in Mirage, not that impressive, but they're in the zone right now.
There was a moment as well, wasn't there, when KQL or Kelly, as they seem to be calling him, I guess that's how he likes it to be pronounced. But he bought an AWP when they had the Galils, and it was at like 14-11, and they lost that round, and it goes to 14-12. And we were sat here saying, he's ruined it, he's blown it. Virtus probably going to win this now. That's like two Galils. He could have bought his team in this, you know, eco round, his force buy. And they went and won the force buy and took it to 15-12.
Yeah, that was crazy. I mean, we were just, okay, this is the way to throw a game, because basically he has 6K, his teammates. He could have saved that not buying this AWP and buying two AKs and have full nades. Now they had two Galils with no nades. So it's like, okay, this is like the mistake. This is going to throw them the game. But they somehow managed to come up big. I mean, the individual performance on them, I'm just amazed. You know, the one duo is like, just like we were discussing, seeing that. Normally the Virtus players should have it. They have the advantage. They're having the crosser on it. And they should win it like 9 out of 10 times. But it was like, boom, an insta headshot. And it was really impressive to see.
I'm speechless still. Like, again,
I want to say as well how much this is going to hurt VODS as a team. I was at Gfinity, I talked to Taz, he had his eye on this one. He was saying, you know, I want to get another major. If I don't get another major, you know, I may have to ask questions about my career. I hope that was said in the heat of the moment because he's such a fantastic character. But they really wanted to win this one. They really believed they could defend the title. And we believed it. I don't think anyone would have called what's happened here today.
Nah, I didn't see this one coming, actually. And I mean, Taz is such a passionate guy as well, and he's performing really well on Mirage there, so I don't think he should question his role in the team at all. I think he played great, actually. And I mean, he's such an important player to have in the team, even though the loss now, his motivation, you know, pushing the guys on is so huge for this team.
All right, well, that kind of wraps this up. What it does set up for you, Mr. NIP, is it's a day of possible afternoon upsets. You know, next up is Cloud9. North Americans taking on your team, number one team in America, or in the world, I should say, not in America. Quick thoughts on that and what you might be a little nervous about, what you're excited about in that before we let you go.
I mean, actually, I think Cloud9 should have lost both the games they wanted to make it here. I mean, it was just, it was an incredible comeback from them, but it was a lot of throws from both Dignitas and Titan. I mean, they should have closed the game out. Not saying they're a bad team, they're really good, but we're in good shape as well. Our practicing before this tournament has been great, and we're confident.
All right. Well, that being said, thank you again for joining us. Pleasure, as always, to have you with us, Heaton.
Nice being here.
And Happy is hanging out with Red Eye. Let's do an interview up on the stage. Take it away, Red Eye.
Thanks very much, Scott. Yes, up here with Happy on the stage, who is very happy. I'll get the early pun in and get that one out of the way. Explain to me what the current feeling is for LDLC and the team right now. What's going through their minds?
There are a lot of feelings. For me, it's a relief because we always exist in quarterfinals of big events. And now we go through the semis when we are the last French contenders. So, you know, we are proud and excited and everything at the same time.
Many people here in the crowd and at home watching, maybe other than all the French fans that you have, would have looked at this matchup and said, VODS Pro have to be the favorites in this. How do you approach the game with that kind of, the crowd may be against you, online's against you, everything's against you. How do you approach it?
As an in-game leader, you know, when you brief your teammates, you just say, okay guys, we have nothing to lose. They are virtus.pro, like the best, one of the best team in the world. So, you know, just play your game because we knew we had the potential to win it. So yeah, I guess we just played a game and we got confidence on the first map and it carried on as the second one.
In terms of importance, that final shot that will live with all of us forever that saw it, when he jumped past on Dust 2 and got the headshot to win the whole of the first map, you guys all jumped up as if you'd won the entire match, but what did that give to you? How did it lift you for the second map? Because you all seem so thrilled about it.
I mean, you know, there are a lot of ways to end a match, but this way, I've never seen that. And we just got ultra confident. And thanks to Kelly, who played an amazing game, we just played our best game.
Second map, it seemed like you were well set for victory, and then VODS Pro showed us that traditional Polish fighting power that they have, kept taking rounds and rounds. Were you worried at any point?
I mean, I know them, how they play and how they act under pressure. And it's like a wounded beast, you know? They almost not get out of the group stage at Gfinity, and they win the whole thing. So you can never rely on them to give up. So yeah, I was a bit afraid at some point, but I knew we could do it because Apex did all amazing stuff on the second map. And we just won it.
Well, congratulations, good luck in the semifinals. I have to ask you the obligatory question, which team do you fancy, anyone in particular?
Cloud9 showed amazing games, and NIP may have showed pretty bad results, shaky results. So I'd say it's pretty even match, but I think we'll play NIP.
All right, well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Happy from LDLC, who are the victors in our third quarterfinal of the day. Don't go too far away. Our final quarterfinal is up next. It's one you won't want to miss. It's Cloud9 versus NIP.